Amita sent me over. She said you might have some kind of wild animal problem.
Hey, Amita, I have no idea what I'm supposed to do here.
Wolves are a common nuisance for Canaan Farm. She's killed off a number of them, but this year they're especially aggressive, and I'm worried about her. There's a den nearby. Clear it out, huh? I think Canaan has supplies stockpiled somewhere on her farm that you can use. And Ajay, skin your kills. We can always use the pelts.
Thank you.
Hey. Badra, how are you?
Good.
I brought you these pelts. I thought maybe you could use them.
It's a good Ajay. But you keep them. She has enough for her Tanka paintings.
I'm sorry, Tanka what?
This one is about the life of a guru. This one is about the demon Yalung. This one is about the goddess Kira. And that one is about Badra, the next Tarun Matara. Tarun Matara is a living goddess, if you believe Sabal. It's no life for a child, being treated as an object, thing. Thanks for your help. Later, we'll show you how to put those to good use.
Ajay, when you have time, go see Longinus. He's a friend to the Golden Path, and he'd be grateful you helped us.
Longinus, you said?
Yes. He's a weapons dealer and a priest, if you can believe that. Longinus is a little crazy, but if you want guns, he's the man you should see. I'll update your map.
Brother Yelana here with some wisdom for my listeners. There's no denying it, we are not... animals here in Kiran. But I am appealing, you guys. I think that we're awful to wildlife because they're fucking assholes. No, that's not it. It's because a lot of us believe in reincarnation, and then there are a lot of jackasses in Kiran. You follow my logic? You know what I'm saying? We ourselves are assholes, then we fucking kill animals, then we come back as the animals, and it's this crazy circle of life where assholes just become assholes. Logic, that's how messed up we are here in Kiran. We hold grudges for so long that we'll even kill an animal on the off chance that it might be the reincarnation of someone we didn't like at some point in our life. I mean, one time I saw a goat, you guys. It had eyes like my ex-girlfriend, so I just killed that goat right on the spot. If I had meat, I'm vegetarian, but I ate the meat and it tasted like my ex-girlfriend. It tasted like pettiness and resentment. That was like, oh, this tastes like nothing. That fucking probably to my own bad karma.
And you, you are AJ. Welcome to my church, away from church.
That sells guns?
Of course. Well, the meek shall inherit the earth, my friend. All they need are some good guns. Revelation 5:5. It is the most invigorating weed. And one of the elders saith unto me, weep not. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, hath prevailed to open the book and loose the seven seals thereof. It is our Savior returned to us as a lion, a warrior. So, I started thinking to myself, when the Son of God is reborn, what gun would he use? When Christ returns to break the seven seals and bring about the rapture, he returns as a lion, yes? A lion needs teeth. What gun would Jesus choose? Deuteronomy 32:47? For there are no empty words for you, but your very life. Or maybe Revelation 19:11. The discretion of a man deferreth his anger.
I don't know what you're talking
about. A soldier knows. A soldier always knows. For we have seen the rapture and survived it. You need guns to do righteous work, AJ. For every gun is a Bible. For every bullet, a sermon. And for every radio tower that you free from pagans' lies, I will give you something. A reward. It is the will of God. Here. This is for the first one.
Vanderport is under attack! We need fighters here
Sabar,
now!
What's happening?
We're under attack! Stay away!
Oh, shit!
Say it to them, go forth into all the world and proclaim the gospel to the whole of creation!
Back then, Audrey.
Your mother and I, with you on her hip. Oh, those were the days. She was never happier than she was back then, and I should say the same for myself. We had such plans, not just for our little family, but for Kirat. It wasn't always like this. I long for those days, but then it's too late. I tried. I really, really did, but this place is ruinous. Try not to let them drag you down, Audrey. Ishwari didn't send you back here for that.
Oh!
Citra, what are you?
I'm all right.
The people need to see her. It'll comfort them.
She's just a child, Sabal, and she's terrified. I'll take her home, and then we'll worry about the people, okay? Thank you.
You're okay.
This is what we get for rescuing Ajay. We hit Paul's house, he slaughters a village.
This isn't on Ajay, it's on me. Can't worry about that now. They took the outpost, and they have hostages.
Fine. The outpost first. Without it, we're cut off from the others.